Good evening, folks. Welcome to another episode of V's Love the Language. August 1st, we aired our first episode. We are almost into 3 months. We have completely finished nouns, and today we are finishing pronouns. We have gone through different sessions, different lessons, learned many parts of English grammar, basics, nouns, and today we will, as I told you, finish pronouns. The last part of pronoun today we are going to take is interrogative pronouns comprising who, whom, and what. Now, interrogative pronoun means we are interrogating, we are asking question about the person or the thing in question. We don't know the name, we don't know what a particular thing is. So we are using these pronouns to ask questions. Who, whom, and what? Who and whom we had covered in relative pronoun. See, this is another tricky thing in English grammar. One or two phrases and words, and nouns, verbs, adverbs covered in one session will be covered in another session also, sometimes, like in this case. It is a relative pronoun. Who is a relative pronoun? Whom is a relative pronoun? At the same time, it is also an interrogative pronoun. Who is? Whom is? Is also a relative pronoun. So, I don't think it will be very difficult for you to understand because we have covered these two in our earlier sessions. Still, now it is coming under a different heading. That's interrogative pronoun. Let me take you through to the three interrogative pronouns. That's interrogative pronoun. Okay, who, whom, and what? These are the three interrogative pronouns. Who is there? Who is there? You can form any number of questions, any number of statements. Who is at the door? Who has done this work? Who has done this work? Who enabled this device? See, in some seconds we have formed 4 sentences. Very easy. Who is there? Who is at the door? Who has done this work? Who enabled this device? Now next is whom. Whom literally replaces who. It's almost similar, slight difference.
John is whom? John is whom I was talking to you about. John is whom I was talking to you about. This is here dwells, lives, okay, here dwells an old lady, here dwells an old lady whom I would like to converse,
involving in the conversation,
that is converse with.
Now with,
it's not mandatory. Even without with,
the sentence is complete.
Sentence gives you complete sense and meaning.
Here dwells an old lady whom I would like to converse with.
Okay, fine. Let's move on to the third interrogative pronoun. That's what? This is what This is what I want you. This is what I want you about. See, this is what I want you about. Probably something unpleasant happened, a negative result. Two people into conversation or three people into conversation. One guy is pointing out, probably that person has given an early warning, early cautionary word that was not adhered to somebody in the group. So that person is saying, this is what I want you about. See, this has happened. See, what is your password? Nobody will share the password.
We all know that.
But sentence is correct. It's complete. What is your password? The usage of what in this sentence is absolutely appropriate. Next. What can I do? What can I do?
Probably a helpless state.
The person left with no option, probably. Asking himself, telling himself,
maybe asking to the other person, what can I do?
Maybe this person is not interested
to try out any option.
Whatever may be the background,
the sentence is appropriate.
Perfectly all right. What can I do?
So these are the three interrogative pronouns we have gone through today. Here comes the curtains to interrogative pronoun and also the pronouns section pronouns in general. It's complete. So let me remind you once again, we have completed nouns and pronouns. We will work out and take the most appropriate or the most feasible or the most suitable section in the next program. Here I conclude. See you again next week, same day, same time. Till then, it's bye from Abhay. Good night.